Father, we do want to just stand in your presence. Lord, open our hearts to all that you have to say to us today. In your name. Amen. I don't intend to get into politics this morning, but you probably have had to have been living under a rock or have your head in the sand if you're not aware of the fact that at the minute in our country we're watching the Conservative Party pick a new leader, perhaps pick themselves apart, but who by default will become our new Prime Minister. Much has been said about Boris Johnson, his charisma, his bumbling attitude, his honesty, or perhaps lack, but some would say he's got what the people voted for. You know, he hasn't changed. He was voted in 2 years ago. They knew exactly what they were getting. His public persona was there for all to see. But others would say that he's very different as a private man. A suggestion perhaps that he's faking it. I think the truth is probably somewhere in the middle, as it often is. But we now see five candidates all left trying to come across as genuine, almost trying to set themselves apart from what's gone before. In our society, no one likes a fake person. You get that feeling when you talk to someone and you can sense that there's nothing genuine. And often Christians can be accused of being fake too. When you go to church and someone asks you how you're doing and your response is, great. Or we act in one way but think or say something else in private, then we're not being true to who we are in Christ and genuine. I think there's a public perception of what a Christian should be. And when they don't see that being acted out in the person in front of them who's professing to be a Christian, they think it's all fake. And Jesus went after the Pharisees for their hypocritical living. They were clean on the outside, but dirty on the inside. Jesus' point was, be genuine to everyone that you encounter. And so our reading is the first part of a longer speech against the Pharisees when Jesus spoke to the people in Matthew 23. It's a chapter where he doesn't particularly mince his words, it has to be said. Verses 1 to 12. Then Jesus said to the crowds and to his disciples, "The teachers of the law and the Pharisees sit in Moses' seat. So you must be careful to do everything they tell you. But do not do what they do, for they do not practice what they preach. They tie up heavy, cumbersome loads and put them on other people's shoulders, but they themselves are not willing to lift a finger to move them. Everything they do is done for people to see. They make their scrolls that they carry wide, and the tassels on their garments long. They love the place of honor at banquets and the most important seats in the synagogue. They love to be greeted with respect in the marketplace and be called rabbi by others. But you are not to be called rabbi, for you have one teacher and you are all brothers. Do not call anyone on earth father, for you have one Father, and he is in heaven. Nor are you to be called instructors, for you have one instructor, the Messiah. The greatest among you will be your servant. For those who exalt themselves will be humbled, and those who humble themselves will be exalted." This is the word of the Lord. And so Jesus is saying to his followers, be genuine in your walk with Christ. It's too easy to maintain appearances. The Pharisees were a group of Jewish men considered the spiritual example of Jesus' day. The problem was that they didn't walk the talk. They looked like they kept the law, but no love seemed to exist in their hearts. In secret, they were morally corrupt. And Jesus tells us to be genuine. Let your outward appearance reflect what God is doing in your heart. See, the image we portray often isn't reality, is it? We clean up the outside of our lives to distract from the mess of the inside. And Paul calls us in 1 Corinthians 11 to be genuine believers. That means that the inside is who people see on the outside. The truth is that we are messy people saved by Jesus Christ. We're all sinners who've been saved by his grace and who continue to get it wrong, but are wonderfully forgiven and wonderfully saved. See, he doesn't expect us to clean ourselves up before we believe in him, because we can't. And he doesn't expect us to act like we have it all together while we serve and follow him. People are to see the continuous work in our lives through our messed up state. One of my favourite things to say to people when they tell me that it's all good people in church is that actually, no, church is not for good people, but for those who know that they are bad and who are grateful for being wonderfully forgiven. See, the Pharisees loved to show everyone how they had everything together. Jesus saw through all of that and called them whitewashed tombs. True beauty comes from the inside. That's what the influence would say, isn't it? But actually it's true. Where a humble and servant heart resides. I wonder what you might be covering up in your heart. Fearful that others might expose you for who you are. Perhaps it's time to come clean to God and say sorry and live a life that is a genuine example to others. Because when we make things right, God restores us. Accept that we're messed up, but God is working in and on you. Don't flaunt your flaws, but don't cover them up either. Amen. So I'm going to finish with the prayer of the day from the Church of England, and then we're going to join together in the words of the Lord's Prayer. Almighty and everlasting God, by whose Spirit the whole body of the Church is governed and sanctified, hear our prayer which we offer for all your faithful people, that in their vocation and ministry they may serve you in holiness and truth, being genuine to who they are, both on the inside and out. To the glory of your name, through our Lord Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And we say together, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Thank you for joining us this morning. Our normal program will be going on this week. Do take care of yourselves, particularly in this very hot weather. Make sure you get plenty of water and don't go out in it too much. On Friday, well, hopefully it'll be a little bit cooler by then, Nigel will be leading a simple said morning of prayer here in church, along with a space to come to have private prayer between 9 and 10:30. Next Sunday, we return to our familiar pattern of St. Anne's at 9, our Holy Communion service. We've got our service for all ages at 10, being led by our youth group. And then in the evening, we'll do something a little bit different. So at 4 o'clock, we're going to be holding a barbecue. We're celebrating all things Lydia as she comes to the end of her 2 years with us as our intern. And then we're going to have a short service at 6 o'clock. So do come with us as she officially graduates her internship with us next month. She's not going anywhere for ages yet, but we are officially at the end of this particular bit of time, so we thought we'd use it as a good opportunity to come together and have a bit of food. So join us. If you are coming and you'd like to have a sausage or a burger, then let me know, although I don't tend to indicate it, so we'll see how we go. But for now, the final blessing. The Lord bless us and preserve us from all evil and keep us in eternal life. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you now and always. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God.